In this video, I will show you how to make a device to improve a simple signal generator's output impedance limitation. This is the signal generator I made, showed on my channel previously. Its power is on already. Now I'm connecting a mini oscilloscope to the signal generator's output terminal for its sine wave output. The waveform is shown on the screen. Taking the 1 ohm resistor as a load for the signal generator. Then connecting it to the signal generator's output terminals, which are the mini oscilloscope's probes connected terminals. Waveform disappeared on the screen. The test mean 1 ohm resistor as a load was not suitable for the signal generator, and its value was too low. However, this DIY device can solve that problem. For the test purpose, named it as signal generator's load enlarger. These are the parts and components for making that device possible. Those will be soldered on this small PCB. This component is a powerful transistor with a heat sink bolted together. That is the DC power socket with his bracket. And those are the connection wires. After the circuit PCB made, all things here will be installed on this wood board. At last. This is the circuit's diagram. The main part is a powerful transistor of 2 and 3055. DC 9 to 12 volt power supply can be used. The power transistor of 2N 3055 and his heat sink are there. The DC 9 to 12 volt power socket is here. That is push type of the DC power on and off switch. A LED indicator is on when both the DC power is on and a load is connected. These are the input wires for this device and will be connected to the output wires for the signal generator. Those are the device's output connection points or terminals for a load and oscilloscope. That's it. This DIY signal generator's load enlarger is ready. Back to the signal generator. Its supply power has been on already. To connect the signal generator and its load enlarger together. The input wire in red connecting to the output wire in brown, which is the sine wave from signal generator. As an example, the black wire connecting to the bracket from the signal generator. Plugging in the DC 9 volt to the load enlarger's power socket. And DC power has been on. Hooking up the mini oscilloscope's probes to the output terminals of the load enlarger. The sine wave is showed on the screen. Connecting 1 ohm resistor to the output terminals of load enlarger. The same sine wave as before showing on the screen. taking the 1 ohm resistor off from the output terminals of the load enlarger. Then connecting an inductor instead. The same sine wave is showing on the screen. Now disconnecting the mini oscilloscope's probes. Then reconnecting them to the different output points. The same sine wave is showing on the screen. As the signal generator alone. Its output impedance is greater than 600 ohms. However, the signal generator and load enlarger connected together. As we've tested already, the output for a load can be any values without distorted original waveform. So this device worked very well. Now you've know how to improve the output's impedance limitation of that simple signal generator and have it done successfully. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe if you have enjoyed the video. Your encouragement is my motivation.